You know what time it is. It's time to hit that subscribe button. And you know just where it's at. It's time to follow my Instagram. That's Geekly Amanda. G-E-E-K-L-Y Amanda. It's the same on Twitter. Make sure to follow me there too. And it's time to get this reaction video started. Yesterday on my live yesterday, every Wednesday morning, well, morning my time, I think it's evening in other places and afternoon and some, but morning my time, I do my live. And this was a big request yesterday, first from my buddy T just requested it, and then other people came in and was requesting it, and I was like, oh, I didn't know this was that a popular video. And they said it's the Dwarka, the Lost City. And this is where the Lord Krishna, they found the underwater. Is it like the city underwater? Something like that. So something's underwater. And this is different from the continent I reacted to not long ago. So y'all ready to check this out? I'm excited. Everybody was requesting this. Y'all ready? Go.
Namaste and good day, friends. Welcome again to Temple Stop.
Get my coffee and everything.
Friends, please. Do you know who is Krishna?
Of course.
Who is Ram?
Yes.
Who is Shiva?
I know it all.
Have they ever existed, or is everything an illusion?
They existed, of course.
Do these names really exist, or as per many experts claim, this is all just a mythology?
No, mythology.
I've always believed it to be true, and for me, it's rather the history and fact of ancient and glorious India. India is a diverse nation with complex geography and sets an example for the world with its various cultures and traditions. In India, there are many ancient and great temples across the country, and every temple has its own unique custom, rituals and traditions. It is believed about India that we have many mysteries that are above the ground, and India also has many more mysteries that are buried underneath its soil, and they are waiting for the right time to be unearthed. One from many such truths is the lost city of Dwarka, which has closed its eyes with all the mysteries and is waiting for the correct time to be unveiled. Dwarka is a town located in the coastal state of Gujarat in Jamnagar district. City of Dwarka is directly linked to India's history and Lord Krishna's life. It is one of the places from the Char Dham Yatra, and every year crores of pilgrims visit this place.
I gotta visit that.
Dwarka exists from Dwapar Yug, and even today it's standing like a strong pillar, which has also been mentioned in all historical books like Skanda Puran, Vishnu Puran, Srimad Bhagavad Gita and Hariyamsa. Dwapar Yug, as per the Sanatan celestial calculation, ended at around 5200 BC and is approximately 7200 years old. And yes, it is much older than the Harappan civilization. Dwarka has been the karma land of Lord Krishna, who is the 8th avatar of Lord Vishnu. Lord Krishna was born in the city of Mathura, but he moved to Dwarka after killing his uncle Kans for the atrocities he was committing. Lord Krishna built the city of Dwarka, and in Mahabharata, Dwarka has also been called as Krishna's city. Dwarka submerged into water due to various reasons. Dwarka being a magnificent city, what was the reason that it got submerged into the sea? Why did the city go underwater? Legends say that it happened because of Gandhari's curse that Dwarka city was destroyed and submerged into the sea. Gandhari was Duryodhan's mother and King Dhritarashtra's wife. She was very upset after the death of her 100 sons in the Battle of Mahabharata. When Lord Krishna met her after the Battle of Mahabharata, she very angrily asked him one question. Gandhari asked Shri Krishna that even though he had the power to stop the war, why he did not stop it and save her sons from dying. And at the same time, she cursed Lord Krishna and his entire kingdom and said that the way she has seen the death of her 100 sons, Lord Krishna will also see the death and devastation of the complete Yadav clan. She also cursed him that Lord Krishna will have to see the death of all his sons and they will all die in the war. As per this curse, the Yadav clan started fighting amongst themselves, and slowly it turned into a full-fledged battle. Lord Krishna's sons died in the battle, and the city of Dwarka got destroyed. The secretary of Shardapit Dwarka, Swami Sadanand Saraswati, says that Dwarka went underwater due to oceanic activities. He also reminds us of what Lord Krishna has said in the Bhagavad Gita, that the day I am not here anymore, no one will be able to save the city of Dwarka. It is believed that Dwarka went underwater due to a tsunami. Many experts and scientists who have been researching on Dwarka for years, experts such as Y.S. Rawat, who was the director of the State Archaeology Department, claimed that 3,500 years back, a tsunami had come and many cities, including Dwarka, went underwater. Around 1970, a marine scientist found evidence of an underwater city near the coast of Dwarka. Followed by latest discoveries in the year 2002, scientists found that a highly advanced civilization of an ancient world was standing untouched below the ocean's surface. With the help of sound matrix, image technology, and sub-bottom profiling, marine scientists were able to find the exact location of the city, including some stone structures.
Did they go down there?
The lost city of Dwarka was found 120 feet underwater in the Gulf of Cambay, Khambat, off the western coast of India. The total length of the city is 7 to 8 kilometers and it is 3 to 4 kilometers wide. After carbon testing this city, it was found that this city is between 7 to 9,500 years old. The most amazing thing about this underwater city is that all the human remains are still intact. After this finding, because Dwarka has been mentioned in Indian ancient scriptures and because it is also linked to Lord Krishna's life, many people have been interested in knowing the facts. Even the scientists doing their research have been very surprised with the findings. What's surprising them the most is that these findings from Dwarka city are more than 5,000 years old from many ancient sites that have been found in the past. Finding this proof has been a surprise for many scientists. This finding has left modern science behind by many years and made the world aware of a long chain of human history. Scientists had divided Dwarka research into two parts. The portion near the water surface is called Bet Dwarka and it is believed that Lord Krishna lived here with his family. Bet Dwarka is also called Shankodhara. Shank means conch and while doing the research, scientists have found many artifacts such as bangles, seal, all made from conch shell. In this excavation of Dwarka, many mud vessels, temple bells, artifacts were found. These artifacts seem to be from a temple or city and according to carbon dating, they are from 7200 BC, which means from the proto-historic period. At the time of research, scientists also found a massive man-made wall of about 550 meters that has been unearthed at the time of low tide and can be easily seen. As per oceanology, Dr. S.R. Rao, the portion near Bet Dwarka, which is now underwater, was submerged into the water at a later stage but not at the same time as the main city of Dwarka. Through research, it was found that because this area was very near to the coast, there have been signs of recent construction there and it goes back to as recent as around 3500 to 1500 BC, similar to the time of the late Harappan civilization.
So this is even older.
The main Dwarka city is underwater and 2-3 kilometers deep into the sea. It is believed that this is from where Lord Krishna administered his kingdom. It is revealed from the carbon dating of the artifacts found here that it's almost 7,500 to 9,000 years old and went underwater due to a 5,000-year-old tsunami.
Many mixed stone
structures were found through archaeological explorations, shapes of which were semicircular, rectangular and square. Besides these big stone structures, big sandstone walls, well laid out architectural structures were also found. Road structures and stone anchors were also found. Something to ponder about, friends. All these artifacts were found in a distance of 7 to 9 kilometers, which gives us enough proof that Dwarka was not only a well-established city but also a very busy port. Scientists found many copper bells, vessels there, which may be used for ritualistic purposes during olden days. Scientists also found some strange structures made of iron near Dwarka, which have been removed and sent to a lab in Ahmedabad for further testing. After all these things, there are many artifacts and things which are still lying underwater, and further research can be done on the same. The first excavation was done in 1930 and the location was found, after which, due to some reason, the research was completely stopped. After 1930, the next research started around 1969 and 70, in which lots of information was found, but once again the research was stopped by the archaeologist. And the last research started in 2002, in which the scientists used more equipment than 1970, and they found many number of new and surprising things. But yet again, this excavation was also stopped by the central government. It is very surprising that even after getting so much evidence, why the research team stopped their work? Why such an important site is not being researched properly? The world still doesn't know the complete truth behind Dwarka and is very eager to know the same. Wouldn't it be apt if the government of India sets up a team of archaeologists and gives them the full freedom to excavate Dwarka site, to which the truth can come out? Once the truth is out, it will reveal a completely new dimension of history of Indian subcontinent and be helpful for the entire human race. If any of you viewers have any knowledge about this, please kindly share in the comments section. If you have enjoyed watching this video...
That's so strange that they had it stopped like that. What are they trying to hide? I need to know. Just like it, I know this is dip, but things like what they hide that stuff. Like, well, here it's like the Area 51, that they're really like aliens from outer space that came here, and the government tries to hide it. Why they want to hide that? Why don't they just tell the truth? This is proof right here that they had the Dwarka existing, and it all links back to exactly that time, like 7,000 years ago. I'm convinced. I believed it before. I was like, I don't think this is... You know I was like, this is some history right here. And then they gonna want to come with proof. And this would only... I don't understand. I don't understand why they don't want it. Maybe they don't want it touched, though. Like, that. Maybe that's the reason. Maybe they don't want them to go down there fooling with stuff, messing up things. I can see that. But I mean, this is, we learn, that's how we study things like this, so to learn from the past. And, well, that was interesting. Now I gotta go to Dwarka. I got everything. I start learning stuff about over there, and planning my trip one day when I go there in my head, and then the list just adds up and up and up as the places I wanna go. It just keeps adding. All right, y'all, let me know what you think. Comments, thumbs, all that. Until next time. Mwah!